Hi everyone, my name is Neha. Welcome back to my channel. Today we'll be discussing about components of router and what is router. So let's get started with what is router. Router is used to connect two or more different networks. Router is a layer 3 device, and you can see here in the diagram, this is how Cisco router looks like. So in computers, we install operating system and run applications like web browser, MS Office, etc. on operating system. So basically, we run applications on computer. But router provides connectivity between two different networks. So now we'll be discussing about the components of router. Main components of router are, we have CPU, we have RAM, NVRAM, flash drive, ROM, and bootstrap. So we'll be discussing about component of router in detail. So the very first and most important component of router is CPU. So just like in computers, CPU is main component in router as well. And our next component of router is RAM, that is random access memory. So our data is temporarily saved in RAM. So if the power goes off, PC will shut down and data will be erased. So it is called volatile memory. So RAM is a volatile memory, and thus its contents will be lost if router is powered off. The next component of router is NVRAM, that is non-volatile random access memory. If we want to store a file or any data permanently, that data will be stored in NVRAM. So in NVRAM, data will be stored even if router gets reloaded. Like in computers, we save our data in, where do we save our data in computers? In hard disk. So our data is permanently stored in hard disk in case of computers. The same way, if you want to store a file permanently, data will be stored in NVRAM. So the next component of router is flash memory. So like in computers, data and operating system both gets stored in hard disk drive. But in case of routers, IOS, that is inter-network operating system, gets stored in flash memory. In case of computers, data and operating system both get stored in hard disk. But in case of router, IOS, that is inter-network operating system, this gets stored in flash memory. So one more thing I would like to add in NVRAM is that if you are performing any sort of task or you are running any sort of configuration, that will run on RAM. But in case if you want to save that configuration, that will be saved or stored in NVRAM. Next, we'll be discussing about next component of router, which is ROM, that is read-only memory. It helps to perform POST, that is power on self-test. Like in computers, while performing POST, it checks it every hardware components, whether it's working properly or not, after it is powered on. The same way, POST is done in routers as well, but it is done by the help of ROM, that is read-only memory. Once POST is successfully done by ROM, once router is powered on, and after that, router will start booting. So we have one important thing, that is, if iOS of a router, it gets corrupt by any chance while booting. So in that case, there's a mini iOS, there's a mini operating system which is present in Rome. So because it's present in Rome, so that's the reason it will never get corrupted. Next, we'll be discussing about Bootstrap. So Bootstrap is a program which helps to load the iOS from flash memory, and the stored configurations from NVRAM in RAM. Or in other words, you can say that Bootstrap is a program which is responsible to bring the router up, finding the iOS on all possible locations and loading it into RAM. So like in computers, we have ports to attach keyboards, printers, mouse, etc. The same way in router as well, we have ports. So let's discuss about ports in router. So we have two types of port in router. One is interface port and another one is line port. So we'll be discussing about interface port and line port in detail. Let's discuss about interface ports. So interface ports connect router and switches to each other. In other words, traffic is routed or switched across interfaces. And we can configure IP address on these ports. Few examples of interface ports are serial interface, Ethernet interface, and fast Ethernet interface. So serial interface is used to connect router to router and router to modem. Ethernet interface is used to connect router to router and router to switch. Ethernet has speed of 10 Mbps, whereas fast Ethernet has speed of 100 Mbps, and Giga Ethernet has speed of 1000 Mbps. We can write Ethernet interface as Ethernet 0 or Ethernet interface 0x0, fast Ethernet interface as fast interface 0 or fast interface 0x0, Giga Ethernet as gig 0 or gig 0x0. Now we'll be discussing about line ports. Line ports are used for configuration purpose. Let's say if we want to give IP on any interface of a router, so we have a router and we have to give IP on any interface of the router, or we want to enable any protocol on that router, then we'll use line ports. We can also configure passwords on line port. So few examples of line ports are console port, auxiliary port, line VTY port. So in case of line VTY ports, there are two requirements before a router or switch will accept a VTY connection. That is, the first one is an IP address must be configured on an interface. Second one is at least one VTY port must be configured with a password. So today we have discussed about components of router. In our next video, we'll be discussing about modes of router. So that's it for today. I hope you've understood components of router. Please like and share this video. And if you are new to this channel, please subscribe to this channel. And do not forget to press the bell icon so that you will get notified for our every new upcoming videos. Thank you for watching.